So last week, I picked up my new iPhone 17 Pro Max and decided to do something different. Instead of restoring all of my apps and settings from my iPhone 16 Pro Max, I opted to start with a fresh install. One of the reasons why I did that was because it forced me to manually download apps again, which is a great exercise because I realized just how many unnecessary apps I had installed. The other reason why I went that route is because it forced me to dive into both my iPhone and app settings to configure them the way that I like. And when it came to Lightroom for mobile, diving into the app's preferences reminded me of all the different hidden and overlooked features and gestures that there are to make the app so much more enjoyable when you use it. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 7 hidden tricks to get even more out of Lightroom for mobile. And for the most part, everything I show you should be available in Lightroom for iPhone and iPad and Android, with one very obvious exception. I'll explain that to you in a bit. Let's dive in. All right, so here we are in Lightroom for mobile on my iPhone 17 Pro Max. And the first tip, this is not one of the 7 that I want to show you, but this is a nice kind of little shortcut. Normally, if you'd want to get to the app settings, you would tap on the try dot on the top right of the screen here, and then at the bottom, you see it says app settings. However, if you tap on the Lightroom app icon on the top left, it'll bring you right there. So super quick, not even counting, that's free of charge, but I just wanted to show you, I'm a big fan of getting to the app settings quickly because I'll often change things around depending on whether I'm recording a video for you guys or whether I'm using Lightroom personally for my own photos. So just tapping that and getting to the app settings menu, it's a nice little quality of life trick. All right, let's start with our first trick over here. And so this basically comes down to personal preference in the grid view, whether you just want to see your photos or if you want to have a bit more info density. So what I mean by that is currently you can see I just have my photos and it's in this kind of masonry grid view. But if I double tap, you'll see here, we have these overlays. And so you can cycle through these. There are various overlays that you can have. So first, this shows you the file type. So you can see here, these are DNGs. If I double tap again, it'll switch to ratings. So if you did apply ratings to your photo, they'll appear here. Next, this I find very helpful. This shows information about the image, like the date and time, the resolution, and the file name of the image. This is also very helpful. This shows the EXIF information. So you can see the aperture, the shutter speed, and the ISO. Double tapping again. If you shared an album using Lightroom Mobile and the people viewing it logged in with their own Adobe IDs, they could actually tap a heart to like the photo or leave a comment. And if they do that, in this overlay here, you would see those little icons. Then double tapping again will hide everything. So for me, generally, I cycle between the photo info and the EXIF info. Now, the second hidden trick is closely related to the first one, except the first one had to do with info density in grid view. The second one has to do with info density in detail view. What I mean by that is just tapping on an image here brings you to detail view. I'm gonna go ahead and hide the edit panel over there. And now watch, just like in grid view, if I use 2 fingers to double tap, we have an info overlay area over here. And you can see it's got a bunch of information, like it tells me that it's a smart preview. It gives me EXIF information, the resolution, as well as the date and time. But if I tap in that overlay area, I can cycle through different pieces of information. So here, this shows me the file name, still gives me the date and time, but it also gives me additional metadata like flags and star rate. Tapping again shows me more information about the image, like the EXIF, as well as the type of lens and camera that was used, which is also very helpful. As you can see, this was the 15 Pro Max. And this shows me additional metadata. So if I included a title or caption, I would see that here, but it also shows me the copyright information. And then we cycle through. Now, that's not the only piece of information that you can have by using a double tap. From this view where we have the info overlay, if I double tap again, we get the histogram, which I find very critical. I always like to have my histogram visible when I'm editing. But when I'm done, if I want to just clear that out, I just need to double tap again and that disappears. So just to recap, double tapping once shows you the info overlay, double tapping again shows you the histogram, and then double tapping a third time hides everything. All right, for the third trick, we're going to go back to grid view. And this is also something that I absolutely love. I'm going to double tap to hide the overlays just for this particular tip. But when I'm normally using Lightroom, I usually have one of those overlays visible. So here you can see I have the grid size set here. But did you know that you can actually adjust the size of the grid? But did you know that you can actually adjust the size of the grid by using a two-finger pinch in or pinch out? So here's what I mean. If I use two fingers to pinch in, you see the grid getting smaller, and I can keep doing that. So it gets even smaller. So you get tons of info density here in one screen, and I can pinch in even more, and it just gets really small, and that's as small as we go. And of course, if we use two fingers to pinch out, you can see us adjusting the grid size until we get to this one-up view, so where each image takes up the entire width of the screen. Now, personally, I usually go between this size or one smaller. But yeah, generally, I'm one size up there. This is where I like to be. Now, remember that I said we're in this kind of masonry view where each image is shown using its aspect ratio. So you have some squares, you have vertical, you have panos, and they basically take up as much space as they need in the grid. But if you want more uniformity, this is where tip number four comes in. If you tap on the try dot on the top right over here, under view options, you see we are in the justified grid, which is what I call masonry, but there's also a square grid. So if I tap that, you'll see now every image takes an even square. And of course, this is paired with the previous tip of adjusting grid size. Now, personally, I prefer the justified grid in Lightroom for mobile, but when I'm using Lightroom on desktop, I'm always in square grid where I can see star ratings and file names and flags and all that stuff. I definitely prefer that. But Lightroom for desktop also does have a justified grid view as well. Just depends on what your preference is. All right, so for my fifth tip, this has to do with whether you like to have your images available locally in case you want to edit them right away or you want to share them without having to download them from the cloud. If you tap on the try dot to the right of any album, you'll see there is a switch called Store Locally. What this will do is it will tell Lightroom to keep a local copy of all of the images in the album. And you know that the album is stored locally because the thumbnail will have that little arrow icon pointing down. Now, there is an important setting that goes along with this. If I go ahead and tap on the trusty Lightroom app icon again to go right to settings, and then I go to cloud storage and sync. Under image quality, the first switch you see there is for only download reduced resolution. Basically, what that means is that if you have that switch enabled and then you turn on the option to store an album locally on your phone, it'll only download smart previews. They are kind of lower resolution proxy image files that give you plenty of resolution if you want to share them as well as edit, but it won't take up as much space as an original. So here, if I were to turn this option off and then turn on the ability to download an album locally, for example, this album, this would take a ton of space. In fact, I don't have enough space on my 512 gigabyte iPhone to store this entire album. And if you just want to see how much space Lightroom is taking, go back to settings and then local storage. And you'll see currently the locally stored copies is only taking 5.18 gigabytes. But if I were to go back over here to cloud storage and sync and turn this option off and then re-download, like I said, it would take a lot more space. So that's why I keep it on. Now, with that said, there is an exception. Right below this setting I just showed you is an option to download originals when using AI tools. I have that enabled. And what that means is, let's say I am using GenRemove, which is an AI tool. Lightroom will automatically download the full res original image because I want that information when I'm doing something like removing an area of the image. I'd rather have all of those extra pixels, which is why I have this option turned on over here. Now, for the sixth tip, I mentioned how there's a tip that is really only applicable to Lightroom for the iPhone. This is it, because it's related to Project Indigo. And if you're not aware of what Indigo is, it's a camera app that was built by some truly, truly brilliant people at Adobe. It's free. I'll leave a link to it. You can download it from the Apple App Store, but it's only available currently for the iPhone, which is why it's an iPhone-only tip. But here we go. If I go and back out into the app settings and I go to early access, you'll see this tech preview on the bottom that says use Indigo for camera. So what does that mean? Well, I'm going to keep it off for now and I'm going to close out of the app settings. On the bottom right, you'll see that blue pill with two icons. The first is to load photos from your album. The second is the camera. Now, currently, if I tap on that, that loads the Lightroom camera. That's been here forever. I mean, you can change from different modes here. You can take your photos, but that's what we have. Now, if I close out and I go back to the app settings and then back to early access and I switch on Indigo for a camera, obviously you'll want Indigo installed on your phone. But here's the thing, and this is unfortunate just because you'll see in a second what I mean, but when I tap on the camera icon, it brings me to Project Indigo. But currently, as you can see, it's not supporting the iPhone 17 series, including my 17 Pro Max. You can see right there that support for the 17 series is coming soon. I've spoken with the guys on the Project Indigo team. They, like I said, are brilliant and amazing guys. And trust me, they want to get support out there as quickly as possible. It's just that it's still a brand new iPhone. Like, this is only a week old. And it takes a bit of time to ensure that we have proper calibration and configurations for this series. So once it's available, what will happen is you'll tap on the camera icon. We'll just swipe over here and it'll open into Indigo. Now, I cannot say enough good things about Project Indigo as far as a camera app. It is so powerful. It has some amazing features that no other camera app for the iPhone has. Things like the ability to do on-device reflection removal, on-device denoise using AI. I mean, it's awesome. Plus, it just has the secret sauce of what it does to take and process images. Nothing else compares. So again, if you have a compatible phone, one of the iPhones that was listed, definitely grab it using the link below. It's free, you know, just have fun with it. And again, if you are a Lightroom user and you want to quickly jump between the apps, if you enable that switch in the settings that I just showed you, it's just a tap away. All right, for the seventh and final tip, this has to do with using two fingers while moving sliders. Now, I've shown this before, but it's so important that it deserves showing it again. Let's start with the light tools here. So let's say I want to see whether I'm blowing out highlights. Well, yes, I can adjust the highlight slider here, but I won't know whether I'm actually blowing out highlights. However, while I use one finger to drag the slider, if I use my other finger and just tap on the image, we get this clipping mask. And so here I can see exactly where I'm clipping highlights. It's really powerful. Same thing goes, like, for example, with whites and blacks and shadows. If I drag with one finger and tap with the other, not just tap, but tap and hold, you get this mask view, which otherwise, I mean, you'd have no idea that this view is here. Let me just go ahead and undo these edits. But where I find it super, super important is not necessarily in the light edit tools, but in the detail section here with sharpening. So with sharpening, the first thing that I like to do is kind of zoom in on an area that I know should be sharp. And just like before, if I start dragging the sharpening amount slider and then tap and hold with my other finger, the image turns grayscale, just like it does on Lightroom for desktop as well as Lightroom Classic. On top of that, if I go back to see the whole image and I swipe up to go to masking, same thing. If I start dragging on the masking slider and then use my other finger to tap and hold, I get this mask view so I can see exactly where sharpening is being applied. It's really helpful, especially, I would say most importantly, with the sharpening masking slider, because that gives you the best visual indication of where sharpening is being applied. All right, so those are just a few of my favorite hidden tricks in Lightroom for mobile. Again, I just installed the app fresh and had to go through and remind myself, you know, how do you adjust the grid size and what do you do to get the info overlays to appear? And so I thought that would be a fun video to show. Now, if you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom for mobile, for desktop, for web, then definitely check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And I've got this video here that shows from Lightroom Mobile's most recent update, there were some really cool new improvements, especially to quick actions. Check that out. Of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated, as is clicking on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.